Fishin Affliction. Hello.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time for those who got it bad.
Well, Mom and Dad's grabbed the kids, it's time for the fishing show. Me and the big dog's gonna go catch them down at the fishing hole. Well, you better stick around, cause you don't know what you're missing. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Grab your hats, grab your baits, don't forget your poles. We're gonna fire up that old Ranger boat and head to the fishing hole. We're gonna try to catch a big one. Yeah, that's what we're wishing. Cause me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, me and the big dog's got that fishing affliction. Yeah, and we've got it bad.
I've got that fishing affliction.
Just like me. Here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here, fishy, fishy here.
What you got, V?
I got that big.
Woo, he's a big one. Man, look at that, Vic. Look at that. Okay, hold on. Let me get the Fraybill net.
I think I do.
It's time to wet a line. It's Fishin Affliction time. Thanks for joining us. This is your old pal, Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fishin Affliction here at the HD Studios. On today's episode, the In the Skillet gal, Miss Vicki Porter, and Dan the Man Firmenich are getting large for a classic largemouth adventure on Old Hickory Lake in Hendersonville, Tennessee. Plus, we'll have a sponsor product spotlight on the fine Stay in Charge systems. Have you picked up your Fishin Affliction second anniversary gift set yet? Get on over to the online store, fishinaffliction.com. Be sure to check out our video archives anytime on YouTube. And our featured Team Fishin Affliction Facebook Friend of the Week is coming up in just a bit. So sit back and relax and enjoy getting large on Old Hickory on Fishin Affliction TV.
Those KVDs. Ooh. See if I can get my mustad net real quick.
Fraybill net.
What did I say?
Mustad.
I was thinking about those mustad hooks. Yes, my Fraybill net. Okay. That's the great thing about these Fraybill nets. Cool. Nice largemouth on Old Hickory. Look at that fish caught it through the nose. You know, sometimes when that happens, right there. They're slapping at that bait sometimes. Well, Vic and I are out here on Old Hickory Lake doing some fishing. Just threw the KVD 1.5 across a little abutment of rock. And I tell you what, that fish just absolutely hammered it. And you can tell by my wardrobe, aside from being windy, it's a very warm day today. It's gonna be maybe set a record. We're gonna turn this fish loose right here. Nice keeper fish on the Old Hickory Lake. And now the masked marauder is going back to fishing.
It's a Lone Ranger.
Ding 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 ding. There's another nice one, Veeps. You see it okay?
I can.
Fraybill net time. All right, come on, Fraybill. All right. Man, we were just talking. We haven't had a lot of bites, but the bites that we've had have been pretty good. This one's on a Strike King red eye chartreuse with a little different color, a little gray on the side. Nice fish, be pretty close to a keeper. I would believe it is a keeper on Old Hickory. Nice fish, isn't it, V?
It's a nice one.
You know, folks, when you're filming out here, like Arabia here, when you're fishing, you know, the wind and trying the video, this fish was caught probably a good 80 to 90 feet away from the boat. But I'll tell you what, when the wind's up, and Vic had just made her cast, and it's always fun and it's always a challenge to do it. What a good time it is.
Well, folks, it's always a great time to be on the water, but sometimes it's a little bit more difficult to film than other times, and this wind at times got up to 20 miles an hour, and then it would just stop and be calm. But that didn't stop the In the Skillet gal from wanting to get out there on Old Hickory and chase those largemouths that are in that pre-spawn pattern. But you know, folks, she is known as the Queen of Crappie, and she can't help but pick up that Strike King Series 3 to make a few casts to see if she can catch those big old slabs or a nice little largemouth.
The little Strike King Series 3. How about that?
Yeah, I just picked up this little crankbait.
This was the crankbait that you caught your big crappie on, and that's why it's on. So
I believe it is.
So yep.
I'm hoping for another record-breaking crappie, but I'll take a little largemouth every now and then, too. There we go.
All right.
They're all cute.
They are, aren't they?
He's glad to get back in the water.
Sun's starting to go down, not go down, but being hit by the clouds, and it's going to be up for about another hour, hour and a half, and let's see what we catch, V.
We'll try it again.
Well, folks, the End of Skillet Gal is on the board with her first little largemouth there in the wilds of Old Hickory Lake, and in a moment, we'll be back with some more fishing action. But speaking of in the wilds, let's go see some pictures from this week's
In the Wild.
Well, folks, the ultimate sportsman, Mr. Jim Summers, has a bird on the ground as he recently harvested this 19.5-pound longbeard. And this is the very first longbeard harvested by Colton Lowry. And it looks like he's got a foot up or two on turkey hunting. And folks, this is Mr. Jimmy Jordan with two big old largemouths. Great fish, Jimmy. And folks, this beautiful little girl, well, this is Kenzie. And this beautiful little girl is her sister, Katie. And they know that they got to have a handful of worms if you're going to do some fishing. What beautiful pictures, folks. Folks, you can send us your pictures at pics@fishandaffliction.com and be sure to visit the picture galleries at our Facebook page and also our website. And be sure to send us your pictures and maybe you'll see them right here on the big screen.
In the wild. Your pictures in the wild.
You know, some of the first spinnerbaits that I ever threw growing up in Michigan had painted blades on them. The new Strike King Tour Grade painted blade spinnerbaits, they have that supernatural look. I mean, when you look at the sexy shad color going through the water, it looks like a school of sexy shad.
It's not just a white blade. It's not just a chartreuse blade. It's a, you know, it's got the natural bait fish look.
When we say Tour Grade, when you pull it out of the package, it's ready to go. It's got every possible component at its very top-notch best.
Smyrna Ready Mix is an established company that handles business daily with integrity and professionalism. Whether you're a general contractor, professional builder, or a do-it-yourself homeowner, SRM has your concrete solutions. With several convenient locations in the Middle Tennessee area to serve you, the only call you need to make is to SRM, ready to serve you with integrity and professionalism.
Tennessee boat operators born after January 1, 1989 must show a Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency issued card as proof of successful completion of a nationally approved boater education exam administered by the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency.
Non-resident boat operators in the state of Tennessee who fall within the age requirement must show proof of successful passage of the National Association of Boating Law Administrators approved boater education course.
Safe boating is no accident. Take a safe boating course.
The Tournament Trail for those who've got it bad. Brought to you by SRM, Smyrna Readiness. Serving you with professionalism and integrity.
Folks, here's the tournament trail results for the Stones River Bass Anglers held on Percy Priest March 25th, 2012. In first place with 15.37 pounds, Mr. Jesse Rigsby. In second place with 7.08 pounds, Mr. Steve Scroggins. And in third place with one smallmouth, but it weighed 4.36 pounds, Mr. John Prewitt. And folks, if you're interested in fishing in this great club, check out stonesriverbass.org, and they are still taking new members.
Hi folks, this is Tim Cramper with the Nashville Bass Anglers. We just finished up our first tournament of the year here on Center Hill Lake. Had a great day, caught a lot of fish. There was 12 guys that caught a limit of fish. And I'm standing here with a winner, Mr. Walt Dillard, with 15.31 pounds. So Walt, what did you do to catch that big stringer of fish today?
Well, I got real lucky. I caught several fish early this morning on top water on a spook. And then I started throwing a Carolina rig, and I just happened to be on a point where there was a lot of fish. And got lucky and caught several of them.
Well, folks, there you have it. There's the winning pattern for today. Check us out next time on April 21st. We'll be at Tim's Ford Lake. Thanks.
And now let's catch up on the tournament trail with Mr. Toby Lillard, Fish and Affliction contributing angler and United States Army veteran.
Hey, everybody. Toby Lillard here. Today we fish AVA Division 32 tournament on Kentucky Lake. I had a 5-fish limit for 12.45, good enough for a first-place win. My fish today came on a rattlehead spinnerbait. Next week, I'll be on Lake Barkley fishing USA Bassin out of Catawba. Now back for more Fishing Affliction.
Well, good luck to all the anglers out there on the tournament trail, and thanks to SRM for sponsoring the tournament trail. And like Toby just said, now back to Fishing Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishing Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by Clark Marine Sales in Franklin, Tennessee. Offering the very best of Ranger, Triton, Sea Arc, Express, Sea Ray, Bayliner, Miranda Pontoon Boats, Centurion Towboats, Yamaha, and Mercury brands. Clark Marine has been serving you with excellence for over 30 years. So for all your boating needs, see Stewart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales.
Get him. Woo. That is what we're looking for. Man. How about that, folks? On that big burner spinnerbait. Strike King. I'll tell you what too, I'm throwing, how about that?
Good fish.
That's a beautiful fish. Dandy fish, dandy. I picked up that spinner bait. Actually, I just stole your bait, Vic. You were on the telephone. And I made one cast to an area that I've been wanting to fish. And how about that? That fish just loaded on and just, look, boy, I'll tell you what, just annihilated that bait. And I've put monofilament on this line here to help float that spinnerbait up. That's striking burner bait. That's about a 1 ounce bait that I'm throwing, and it's a great bait. Big blades, it makes a big wobble, and I want to keep that bait up in the zone a little bit more than what fluorocarbon would do. So I've got that Senshi monofilament on by Seaguar, and I'll tell you what, just a perfect combination. Throwing it on that 7-foot co matrix with a 710 US reel. Just a dandy. Okay, well, let's take a still picture and then we'll get that fish back.
Well, folks, as you might have heard me say, I caught this beautiful fish because I actually stole Miss Vic's pole while she was on the telephone and made one cast with that burner Strike King spinnerbait on and caught that beautiful fish. All because I stole Miss Vic's pole. Well, really more borrowed it. And speaking of using something that ain't yours, well, turnabout's fair play, as Miss Vic did the same exact thing to me just the other day, as we had just gotten those Strike King Series 3XDs in, and I was tying one on, I put it down for a second, I turned around, and it was gone, and she was catching good old hickory largemouths on my 3XD and my fishing pole. Well, folks, that's what I get for stealing her spinnerbait.
I have got a 3XD Sexy Shad Strike King.
Is that awesome or what?
It's a good fish. Is he a keeper?
We're going to measure him. That is awesome.
If not, he's close.
And you know what was really cool? We've never fished there, have we?
No.
And we've not been fishing for how many casts? 15?
Yeah, maybe.
Maybe. Found what we were looking for, and look at that. That's a beautiful fish. I can't tell if that fish is spawned out. It looks a little bit thin, but okay. As a general rule, we don't want to keep them out longer than we can hold our breath. But with that said, let's do what we need to do. We'll measure it, and we'll go from there.
All right, good deal.
What's the verdict?
All right, we measured him, and he is a keeper here on Old Hickory. He's a little bit over 14, and it's got to be 14 on Old Hickory to keep. So, but it is your lucky day, because I'm going to put you back right now. Try to catch your granddaddy.
Beepaloo, can I have that bait back? What do you
no.
get? What do
you? You keep wanting to take this bait.
What do you have? What's the fish?
No.
Oh no! I'm sorry. I've got my line
oh,
and.
No.
Oh my gosh, V. All right, hold on. Let me get the fray bill net. Oh, in the water, keep them in the water, kind of right there. Okay, hold on. Oh my gosh, swing them to me. You big old. Oh, right here. Bring them. Oh.
Yay! That's a good one.
That's awesome.
Look at the little glove malfunction. Look at my good fish.
Good.
I'm so excited.
Are you kidding me? That's awesome. V, that's just outstanding. Throwing that 3XD for the first time, another place. Have we fished this place ever?
No. We came here today just on a whim, so we're going to try it. And
man, that's beautiful.
It's two keepers for me so far.
Let's box this fish just in case you catch 14 limits.
Because I might. I'm on a roll.
We'll call you Butter because you're on
butter.
A roll. All right, awesome.
Does it matter which side?
Just go ahead and drop them in. I'm going to do what I need to do.
Get another one.
I know, but dadgum, can I have that bait?
No.
What do you got? Is it a white bass?
It might be.
It is. Oh, it's a nice largemouth. And he just,
oh,
here.
I got him
it's a, well, I don't think you snagged him. He hit the bait, I'm sure. Beep-a-loo.
Yes. Is this another keeper? He looks like it.
All right, let me help you.
Yeah.
And we'll get him here.
Let's help.
Yeah, let's get him out here.
Let's
you
help
take
him.
This,
he's
and we'll
got
go
his
from there.
Side stuck there.
I didn't tell you how long that fish
no,
is.
No, you just measured him. How much did he measure?
You can put him in the live well.
All right.
You can put him in the live well for your
good
hero
deal.
Shot.
Good deal.
My gosh. That's how many fish have you had on today?
I've had three, and they've all been keepers.
That's awesome, and you're throwing the sexy shad color 3XD.
The 3XD, Strike yeah. King.
That's so awesome.
It's been
that's
an awesome bait today. The
it
fish
has.
Are really liking it.
You know, that's that color is just, hey, where'd you go?
Oh, sorry.
Oh, here you go. There's the color. I mean, let's show the color.
I was going to get the color, but it's stuck in the net.
It's okay. There it is. You know, that's the great thing about these fraybill nets, is that they're not made out of a nylon. They're made out of plastic, so the lures, actually the hooks never get inside fabric. So it just takes a little bit of working like that, and there it is. And it's in my hands. I should get the scissors and I should chop it off.
No.
All right, go back to catching.
So this is the only one in existence. I'm sure of it.
Just go catch it.
Well, folks, I promise you, you won't have any problem finding a Series 3XD Strike King crankbait at your favorite tackle store. And be sure to pick you up a handful of them, because what you just saw was the very first time that we ever took it out of the package and fished it. Well, one of us got to fish it. And don't forget to tie on one of your favorite Strike King spinnerbaits, because largemouths absolutely love it.
How about that? Now here's the importance, folks. See it? That fish is caught 100% on that trailer hook. Okay, just two casts after that last fish. How about that, huh? Boy, I tell you what. It's great to get into these fish when they're like that. And I'll tell you, one of the things that you need to make sure that you have is a good quality net, and there is no better net made than the ones that Fraybill make. And the biggest lesson is to have them out on the deck so you can get net those fish. I'm notorious for having them locked down and making a run and forgetting to put them out. But this time, I got my Fraybill net right here, and I'm picking up that Strike King spinner bait, 1 ounce, and catching some good quality fish.
Did you steal that from me?
Well, folks, there's a whole lot of Strike King bait stealing going on as Miss Vic and I are fishing Old Hickory Lake. And in a moment, we'll be back with some more fishing action. Well, right now, it's time to hear from the voice of Fishing Affliction, Mr. Matthew Gillen, as he tells us about the weekly Team Fishing Affliction special from Clark Marine.
Okay, thanks, Dan. Here's a 2006 Nitro 640LX. As a Mercury 90 engine, features a Lowrance X37TX depth finder, and has a Motor Guide 46 Pro Series trolling motor. Call now for special pricing or cruise on in and see Stewart and the award-winning team at Clark Marine Sales, Baytonsville Road, exit 61 off I-65, Franklin, Tennessee. Now let's scoot on up to the kitchen and see what Miss Vic's got cooking for us this week.
In the Skillet with Chef Vicki Porter is brought to you by Kleepy.com, turning your precious memories into video treasures.
Welcome to In the Skillet. I'm Vicki Porter, and today I'm going to show you a different way that you can use cauliflower as a side dish. This recipe is for cauliflower au gratin, and now for the ingredients. You will need cream of mushroom soup, milk, minced garlic, cauliflower, grated Swiss cheese, and crumbled bacon. After steaming our cauliflower in the microwave for about 3 minutes, we're going to add in our milk. Now let's add some garlic. Add half of your cheese. And now add your cream of mushroom soup and get this all mixed together really well. Now spray your baking dish with cooking spray. And we're gonna add our cauliflower to this dish. After smoothing it out in the dish, we're gonna add the rest of our cheese to the top. And now add our crumbled bacon. Now we're gonna bake this at 350 for 45 to 50 minutes. After this finishes cooking, you will be ready to sit down and enjoy this delicious cauliflower au gratin. You can find this recipe at intheskillet.com, and be sure and click on the YouTube icon to see this recipe as well as all of my other In the Skillets. And folks, if you have a recipe that you would like to see here in the Skillet, you can leave it either on the In the Skillet Facebook page or the Fishin' Affliction Facebook page. You can also email it to me at vicki@intheskillet.com. And you might see your recipe in the Skillet right here on Fishin' Affliction TV. I'm Vicki Porter. Tune in next week to see what's cooking in the Skillet.
One of the questions I've gotten asked most through my years at the Tennessee Wildlife Resources Agency is, can you hunt from a boat? And the answer is yes, most of the time you can, as long as you're not under power while you're hunting. You can't run up to a bunch of ducks with a motor going stop and take a shot. You got to be floating or paddling. It's a great way to hunt turkeys, squirrels, ducks, a lot of things, but you just can't be under power. And the other thing is, you got to make sure you know who owns the land alongside, say, the river that you're fishing. It's not always a Corps of Engineers, it's not always TVA. Sometimes it's a private owner, and you have to make sure you have permission to do your homework. It's a great way to hunt, but make sure you're doing it right. I'll see you next week right here on Fishin' Affliction.
Folks, on today's Fishin' Affliction product spotlight, I would like to tell you about the incredible charging system from Stay In Charge. This is what Fishin' Affliction TV uses to charge each and every one of our deck of batteries, whether we're in the garage with our boats doing nothing, or driving down the road on the way to the chute, or even on the water. Our Stay In Charge systems keep our batteries absolutely maxed to the highest level, and they are extremely friendly to every type of battery, whether it's an acid battery, a gel battery. A Stay In Charge system in your boat will keep your batteries charged to the max. So get on over to Stay In Charge, check them out, and now, back to Fishin' Affliction.
Welcome back to Fishin' Affliction, and this segment of the show is brought to you by U.S. Reel, when performance means everything. Harris Rods, don't follow, lead. Cigar Line, always the best. Mustad Ultra Point Hooks, stays sharper longer. Onyx Life Jackets, keeping you there. Fraybill, trusted gear since 1938. Blakemore's Real Magic, the name says it all. Deca Gel Batteries, Stay In Charge Battery Charging Systems, Rugged Electronic Mounts provided by Ram Mounts, Lowrance Electronics by BBGMarine.com, and Tournament Wear. Look great, feel great, do great.
Another fish, folks. Oh, he's on. Come on.
You want to get the net?
Yeah, I'm going to get it. Man, he's a beautiful fish. We have absolutely hot fish today. Look at that, folks. Look at this. Look at that. Boy, I tell you what. How about that? Have we caught some fish today?
We have.
What a beautiful, beautiful fish. The staging, doing what they love to do. And there it goes. They love to do that too, don't they, V?
They love to go back to their home.
They do.
Well, folks, after catching this beautiful largemouth on that Strike King red eye, I reached down to grab that Aris rod that had that Strike King burner spinnerbait on, and it was gone. And guess who had taken it?
What you got, V?
I got something big.
Woo, he's a big one. Man, look at that, Vic. Look at that. Okay, hold on. Let me get the Fraybill net.
Get the net.
I think I do. Oh, my gosh. I'm not tell you what. Let me just reach him. Oh, how about that, V?
All right.
Woo.
Look at that.
What about that, Vic?
That's a good one for the day.
That's a good one any day. What do you mean? That is awesome. What are you throwing?
Fish.
You're throwing that's the big Strike King.
I got the big spinner bait.
Yes, you do. That's the, that one right there. That is the, the burner. That's right. Yeah.
What's it called?
The burner. That's the Strike King.
Strike King burner?
Yeah.
It's little chartreuse and white.
Yeah, it's a great bait. Hold that fish up, V. Congratulations, huh?
Thank you.
Yeah, that's awesome. And we're fishing a little bit shallow. You can see that it looks like it to be a female that might be getting ready to do some spawning, not quite ready yet.
She's got a big belly.
She sure does. Congratulations. That's awesome. Let's take a still picture with your camera,
okay,
and then we'll get her released.
Okay.
About a 3-pound fish, V. Congratulations. That's awesome.
Nice one.
All right, let's get her back in the water.
Okay. There she goes.
How about that?
That was awesome.
That's cool, huh?
Yeah, good deal.
Hey, can I borrow that spinnerbait?
Tomorrow.
Thanks. I appreciate it.
Well, folks, Miss Vic didn't let me use that spinnerbait on this trip, but I did grab that Tennessee triple rig, tricked out with those Strike King 3X grubs, and, as you've already seen, caught Rockzilla, the second big rockfish that I've caught in less than 7 days. And it just goes to show you, folks, no matter what Strike King bait you're throwing, you got a great chance of catching fish.
And folks, don't forget to pick up your collectible 2-year anniversary Fish and Affliction gift package from our online store there at fishandaffliction.com. An embroidered Fish and Affliction sunshield hat that has a sun protection factor of 45, has that extra long brim for those hot summer days, and the Fish and Affliction brand eyeglass retainer that'll keep these Strike King sunglasses on your head at high speeds or for an enjoyable day of fishing. So get on over to our website, fishandaffliction.com, to the online store to pick up your collectible 2-year anniversary Fish and Affliction gift package. Not every day you get into crappie like that on Old Hickory Lake.
And folks, on next week's episode of Fish and Affliction TV, so many of you have asked to see some big old slab crappies being caught, and that's exactly what you're going to get. As it is crappie time here in Tennessee, and we're going to be doing some slab hammering on some big old crappie, along with a visit from the legendary crappie guide himself, Mr. Harold Morgan. So tune into Fish and Affliction Television next week, and you'll see.
This is Vicki Porter, the queen of crappie fishing.
And this is Harold Morgan, the crappie fishing legend.
Oh, get out of here.
This week's Team Fishing Affliction featured Facebook friend is Sloan Riley. And thanks for being our Facebook friend. For your chance to join in the fun and become an official Team Fishing Affliction featured Facebook friend, simply like us on Facebook. And be sure to write a comment on our wall. As always, a big thank you to all of our national and local sponsors for providing us with the most advanced technology and highest quality products and services. Be sure to visit each of our partners online through the sponsor links page on our official website at fishandaffliction.com. And this is your old pal Matthew Gillen, the voice of Fish and Affliction TV, hoping that you'll tune in next week, because there's no doubt that Dan and the Big Dog got it bad. They've got Fishing Affliction for those who got it bad.
People don't know, but these things will talk to you.
I love Fishing Affliction. Yes, I do.
And he's saying,
don't throw them Strike King baits around me no more.